in a time and space divide. But how would the universe survive?
Has officially surpassed Mars as the dominant technological force in the galaxy. Thanks to this, perhaps our greatest triumph.
And here is our greatest triumph. What is it again?
It's a rocket, Captain.
Not just a rocket, Cadet. This one runs on the same fuel we do. Air.
That's what we breathe, Captain. Oh. What about Asmus 1 through 12?
We're certain nothing will go wrong with Lucky 13. That's why we need a brave, fully insured test pilot. What do you say, Dodgers?
Will I get to be on TV?
Only if something goes wrong.
I'm in.
Now, if anything malfunctions, hit the kill switch. That's the big red button marked kill switch.
Chief, relax. I'm a captain. I fly spaceships for a living.
Duck Dodgers, Captain, a duck barely alive. Gentlemen, we can rebuild him. We have the technology. We have the capability to make the world's first cyborganic duck. Duck Dodgers will be that duck. Better than he was before. Better, stronger. Well, stronger and faster, anyway. Ah, Dodgers, good, you're awake. How do you feel?
Yipe!
Listen to me, Dodgers, we had to take some bold steps to save you.
Bold steps? You turned me into a cyborg!
Well, technically, yes.
Ah, my legs too? I'm a freak!
Temporarily, but while you heal, these cyborganic shells, which are the peak of cyborganic technology, will enable you to do everything you did before, and more.
Really? Awesome!
Dodgers, those cyborganics aren't toys. They cost $6 wazillion.
Is that a lot?
It's so much money, we actually had to make up a number, then multiply it by 6 just to count it.
Don't sweat it. I'll be careful.
As comforting as that is, I'm assigning you a cyborganic mentor. He's a retired lieutenant colonel and was the first man to receive cyborganic implants. His name is Steve Boston. You probably know him as the cyborganic man.
Doesn't ring a bell.
Well, he's waiting downstairs.
Can we take the elevator?
Nope.
There was already a hole in the floor. Why make another?
It's like I'm invincible!
You believe that makes one of us.
You Dodgers?
And then some, sir.
Here. That'll hide your cyberganics. And it'll withstand everything from napalm to grape juice.
Ooh, polyester. Not too shabby, eh, cadet?
Yeah. Do I get one of those?
Well, that depends. Are you cyberganic?
No.
Well, then there's your answer. I'm afraid they're designed for cyberganic use only, cadet.
Yeah, cadet, back off!
Let's head out.
Yeah, cadet, let's head out. No offense, sir, but...
Call me Steve.
Really? Okay, Steve. That's cool. Steve. Steve. Steve.
Stop calling me Steve.
Right. Anyway, Steve, I'm sure you have better things to do than this. I mean, cyborg to cyborg. We both know I don't need a babysitter.
Yeah, I know.
You do?
Sure. To be honest, I'm not here for you. I'm here for me.
Why? Are you sick?
No, I'm bored. I retired because I needed a break. Now I need a break from my break. I want some action.
Hate to say it, Steve, but there's not much action at a hospital.
You're right. Ever been to Indianapolis?
What's in Indianapolis? Guys!
And here they come into the final lap of the Jet Car 5000. Dodgers and Boston have tied for first place on foot!
We won! You believe it, and they won.
I've come back through time to annihilationate you and golf.
They sure don't make us like they used to, eh, Steve?
I can't see a thing.
On our left is the Grand Canyon, and on our right you'll see a man and a duck standing on the wing.
Nuts.
That will be $79, sir.
The latest spy satellite photos from Earth, sir.
I don't believe it. Another cyborganic breakthrough for Earth. They're building a better tomorrow, and we can't even build a better stereo! Perhaps we need a bigger secret underground lab.
It's not the lab.
Then we need more research money. $6 Wazillion should do it.
First, that's not a real number. Second, why compete with Earth? They're doing all the work for us.
Of course. Why make cyborganics when we can simply take theirs? Hey, maybe that'd work for our stereos, too.
Heads up, Steve. Here comes the football stadium.
Another key pass by the duck, Bert. But how long can he keep this up?
Forget the duck, Frank. Worry about the stadium. It's never faced this kind of spectacular, relentless passing attack.
I still don't see why I can't play.
We got some Martian ships incoming.
Oh, yeah. Must be 24 easy.
It's an invasion. We need to warn IQ and scramble the fleet!
No, they're still a few million miles away. Plenty of time.
Yeah, cadet. Plus, Steve and I can handle a few Martians by ourselves. Now, who wants a hot dog?
But the Martians are coming.
Yeah. Hot dog first, Martians later.
Fine. But I'm not buying.
Professor, I think a Martian armada is invading Earth.
For the last time, Keith, that telescope only works at night. It's sunny outside. Why don't you go to a beach and enjoy your youth?
Wake up! All that money and they couldn't install an alarm clock.
Thanks for buying the hot dogs, cadet. Cadet, where'd he go?
Not sure, but maybe our new friends over there can tell us.
You are now both prisoners of Mars.
I don't think so. Try again.
Surrender? There is no escape.
Even you don't believe that.
We have fresh pie?
Pie? What kind?
All your favorites.
Impossible! You'd need an oil tanker just to carry them.
That's a shame. You should never lie, especially about pie.
We are. Can you take some pictures of me and Steve by the pyramid? And you should clean up before we go brief IQ. You're a mess. Oh, and you're on fire. Chief! Hey, Chief! Got some interesting news about the Martians. Looks like you already heard it. IQ, are you okay? Andy, is it decent?
Help! I'm trapped by my work!
You too? Great. Let's ditch these dead-end jobs, hop on a train, and see where the rails lead us.
Don't think he meant it like that.
Oh.
Stop! What are you doing?
Please, you're breaking everything!
Thanks for saving me.
Our pleasure, Chief.
Did Centurions do this?
They were looking for cyborganic beings. At least they didn't capture you.
Nobody captures us unless we want them to. Right, Steve?
Why would you want them to?
I don't understand. Why would they come here looking for cyborganics?
Before you, we tested the technology on a subject with anatomy similar to that of humans.
What, like a monkey or a chimpanzee?
Close. Actually, you may know him as Bigfoot.
Bigfoot? The mythological monster?
Monster's such a strong word. He's actually quite friendly. In fact, he works in the building.
Wait, I know that guy. Harry? Really big feet? Oh, his name's on the tip of my tongue. Carl?
Anyway, the Centurions broke in, interrupting critical research. I tried to fight them off, but there were just too many. That's when Bigfoot charged in. They fought like a wild beast, but they found his weakness and exploited it. Poor Bigfoot. He always loved pie.
Who doesn't?
Wait, they were after all the cyborganic beings on Earth? But that means Jamie.
Jamie? Who's Jamie?
Jamie Winters, the cyborganic woman.
So, no Dodgers or Boston. If our scientists understood cyborganics, we wouldn't have to kidnap people.
I know. That's why I've hired an external robotics specialist for us. I present Dr. Maniac!
Isn't he a mad scientist? And not a very good one.
He's turning his life around, taking night classes, wearing pants, talking to his keys less.
No, not now. Later, I promise.
Okay. And what about Dodgers in Boston? That's Boston's wife. Sooner or later, they'll come looking for her.
Exactly. And when they do, they'll fall right into our little trap.
Wait for backup. Trying to rescue Jamie alone is madness. We can't afford to lose you. More specifically, we can't afford to lose wazillions of dollars.
I appreciate the ride, but you don't have to help me rescue Jamie. It's too risky.
Nonsense, Steve. Where you go, I go. That's what best friends do.
We barely know each other.
And yet we're so close, it's scary.
I don't know what I'd do without Jamie. It's like we were made for each other.
Isn't it that technically you were made for each other?
Yeah. Just like you and me, Steve. CFF. cyborganic friends forever.
That's close enough, mister.
I'm getting a faint cyborganic signal. Mars must have Jamie in their secret underground lab. It's a good thing their secret underground lab is so easy to find.
Excuse me, doctor, shouldn't I be asleep?
You are asleep.
Actually, she's not.
Oh, that's a shame, because boy, this is gonna hurt. Are you a doctor?
No.
Are you sure? Because we should really have a doctor here.
You're a doctor. Your name is Dr. Maniac, remember?
Oh, right. Well, never mind. Scalpel.
I told you, we don't have a scalpel. You were supposed to bring one, because you're a doctor.
I am?
Perhaps we should rethink this. I'm with her.
Oh, give him a chance. This is his first surgery.
First?
Oh, didn't I mention that?
Didn't I ask for a scalpel?
Steve, I was wondering, how come when you cyberganics do anything dangerous, it's always in slow motion?
Huh. Never thought about it. To be honest, I don't know.
I do. It's because everything looks cooler in slow motion.
Steve! They're right behind me. We have to get out of here. Now.
Boy, she's kind of bossy.
Jamie, how did you... Forget it. It's okay. You're safe now.
See? I knew she was nothing but trouble.
You're not my wife. You're a robot imposter.
Must have been her good arm.
Come on, Jamie's still inside.
You see, our robot imposter barely even slowed them down. That's why we need cyborganic technology.
I agree, but I highly doubt he can help us get it.
Seriously, I'll tell you everything I know about cyborganics if you'll just stop making balloon hats.
Excuse me, these are neuro-inhibitor detonators.
They're balloon hats.
Balloon hat!
Okay, fine, big boy. They're balloon hats filled with explosive gas. Are you happy now?
Not really.
Okay, he's a friend of my uncle's and he needed a job. He does have experience as a circus clown.
How do they expect us to sneak in if we can't see anything?
Hold on. I think I have a leftover glow stick from Halloween.
You are now all prisoners of Mars.
Do we really have to do this again?
Nope. Go right ahead.
Good to see you again.
Yeah, you too.
Getting all dizzy. Losing all strength.
I think I'm gonna be all sick.
They're just a spinning tunnel, guys. No big deal.
I thought you said your vortex tunnel would stop them. No, it didn't. They're right there.
Who's right there?
Sorry. Welcome, gentlemen. I'm sure you've noticed your friend's accessories. The hats, while ridiculous, will destroy the lab and everyone in it if removed. As for the collars, they use high-voltage shocks to turn you against each other. Whoever survives will have the honor of joining our new army of cyborganic warriors. You're sure the collars will work?
Work? I never said that. No.
So, Steve, I'm thinking you should fight Bigfoot since you have more cyborganic experience. Okay. But if you want to trade at any time, just let me know. Hey, big fella, remember me?
Dark?
That's right, it's your old pal.
Enough chit-chat. Start fighting.
Dark!
Ah! Is this about people tracking mud across your freshly mopped floors? Because I'm not the only one who does that every day.
Jamie, just hit me. I can take it.
Are you sure?
You don't have to hit that hard.
Sorry, got a little carried away.
Sorry again, honey.
Captain, you have to help Steve.
Help Steve? He's fighting the girl. I'm the one who needs help.
That hurt, sweetheart.
Steve can't fight his wife. You're the only one who can stop this.
Hey, I warned him. He was too in love to listen to his best friend.
Then do it for your other best friend.
Pizza?
No, me.
Fine. But don't tell Pizza about this.
Look at him, Captain. Isn't cyborganic love grand?
Did you hear a loud bang?
I am so happy for them. You know, we should buy them a gift. Something red.
Come on, Dr. Maniac. I hear they're hiring at Waffle Warehouse.
Oh, no. Don't say waffles. Anything but waffles. Wait a minute. I'm thinking of pancakes. Never mind.
I'm just so glad all of you and your cyborganics are headed home safe and sound. Wait, Dodgers, where are your cyborganics?
Well, Chief, the bad news is I broke them, but the good news is I'm fully healed.
Dodgers, do you know how much money you've cost the Protectorate?
Well, hold on, this may take a while.
Actually, IQ, Jamie and I have some news, too. We want to come back to work for the Protectorate.
This little adventure made us both realize just how bored we were.
So don't go too hard on Dodgers. He and the cadet made it possible.
And technically, that means you're up $6 Wazillion, not down.
It's 12 if you count Bigfoot. Wait, Dodgers, where's Bigfoot?
Don't fear, my jumbo-footed friend. Soon we'll conquer this waffle warehouse, and then Mars, and then... more waffle warehouses, all thanks to my latest invention.
Stereo!
Okay, that's what I'm gonna call it. The stereo. Oh, we make a fine team, you and I.
Hey, knock off that racket!
Quick, my furry ally. More batter!
Doc.